I didn't fully leave Cursor when I switched to CodeCode and OpenCode, but it did change the way I build from the ground up. Thinking about leaving Cursor, here's what my AI development journey taught me. So this all actually started when Cursor did their unannounced price change in June. So they went from a standard $20 per month to a usage-based pricing model. And they forgot to mention to anyone that this happened. This wasn't the main reason why I changed. I had a few problems before that where I was experiencing some UI freezing from Cursor. There was a few memory leaks. But I think the biggest one is agents just felt inconsistent between updates. So I had a set of rules that I was using and I'm very proud of, and they really did work. But sometimes often updates didn't work as well as it did in the past. And I had no insight to why that was. And that really frustrated me. And that actually led me to trying out tools like CodeCode and OpenCode. I did have to change my approach, because if you are moving from an IDE to CLI tool, it doesn't really work the same. There's a few concerns I had. But one of the main concerns I was very scared of when moving across, because I really enjoy this feature from Cursor, where you can come and accept different edits in line from the code change you have. I'm using the in file edit here with the 1K, but you could do it for the agent point as well. And this was the biggest thing I was worried about. What I found was I did change my approach a bit. And the way that Cursor works versus CodeCode works is a bit different. So CodeCode really started using the CLI commands like grip. They started actually parsing entire files to try and understand the whole code base each time. And at first this felt a bit weird because you're using so much context, but it was actually producing better results for a lot more complex tasks. They felt more consistent. You actually knew what was going on. So changing to CodeCode, I really had to change some of the approaches I took, mainly with interacting with it. So knowing that I couldn't do the inline edits each time to accept each line that I was very used to with Cursor, I had to do a different approach. But when you actually start using CodeCode, especially for if you're trying to understand a code base before it does a class, it actually reads every file that seems relevant to actually execute that task. And sometimes that actually produces better results than Cursor. The reason being is Cursor actually uses this embedding function. If you go to settings in Cursor, it has this indexing doc. It actually uses this code base index here. Without going into too much detail, Cursor uses indexing to do semantic search when you're doing a query, or it's trying to find a relevant function. There are some pros and cons to this. And this is where a lot of the inconsistencies of how Cursor was doing things in the past came from. I understand now they've kind of changed it a little bit, but for this video, that was the issue back then. CodeCode will actually go and read each individual file. So it'll look through the base and then try to understand where the code changes could be wired according to the file. And then in the code itself, it might reference where the additional bit of code that is needed to grab it. And that's why when CodeCode and all that tries to make the agent or code.md file, so it doesn't have to do that each run. So I really changed the way I thought of how I work with AI tooling. It wasn't just a track and go, it was a more planned, structured approach. You really had to guide CodeCode from the beginning, what it needs to do, and make it pinpoint. The instructions had to be very clear. When Cursor, you could be very lenient with your instructions, and it would sort of pick it up and you'd chat more with it and then plan your route and then execute it. Where Code, I felt if you weren't maximizing your initial prompt, your results will work. So it felt more you had to control what you were putting in. I did run into a problem with CodeCode. I could only use, Anthropic model. That's kind of actually what led me to OpenCode. I've been following the guys who made SST for a while now, and I'm just a big fan. When they started using OpenCode, I decided to give it a test when it was in a bit more of a stable state. What I really liked about it was provider agnostic. So you could run any different model within it, you know, that being open source models or different model providers. And I just found it very fast compared to CodeCode. It's if you do each of them side by side, OpenCode just seems to run very quick. I also enjoyed that I could actually see what was happening in the back end of the code. One of the main advantages I found with using these AI CLI tools is, well, one, we could actually determine what the behavior was going to be. It was always running like a stateful operation. It felt like context was separated between agents, and we could verify that. It just felt a lot easier to work with. Even though I was having great success with the AI CLI tools, I still found myself going to Cursor for a few little things. Cursor's really great code exploration, and I really like the way the MCP management works and how you can integrate with documentation. To show this, I'm just in the OpenCode repo right now. And say if I just want to quickly find where something is, although I could ask Cursor, hey, how are sessions managed in this repo? And it's going to use that index, so that embedded index of the codebase, to help understand how this code works and then give me an answer back and then refer to the different files. This makes it a lot easier to chat and understand what the codebase is at a glance. So this method of actually just using Cursor to chat with its embedding of the codebase really saves you a lot of time. You can ask it different questions and it can grab different linked information about the codebase and give it back in a readable format. This saves you a lot of time. You can't underestimate how amazing this is. The other bit is I really liked the MCP part. If we go to the MCP part of integrations, you could turn on and off different ones. And what I was using this for, it's actually not for coding, was I was using some like life hacks. So I would connect it to my Notion, so like the social post here. I could go through here and run my different MCPs. And I really liked this. It worked quite quick and easily with MCPs. I didn't have to manage it through my configs all the time. And this just felt like a very easy way for me to quickly manage my MCPs with Cursor. There are some limitations, but for the most part, I really like the way you manage MCPs through Cursor. Just feels very simple and easy to do. And the other part about Cursor I really like is that you can interact with documentation. So on screen here, I've got how you can go to docs here. In doc, you could actually talk to different docs. So I can actually go to the open code docs here and actually start using that as a reference point and just speaking to those docs in the chat to get the relevant context. So I hope you're starting to see a bit of a trend here. Both tools have different strengths. So I hope you start to see there's a trend here. Each AI tool has its own lifespan. And this led me to this hybrid strategy. I started using Cursor for more of the code-based navigation and exploration to look up and just do some visual planning. And then I actually would make my initial query prompt that I was going to use in my task, and I'd pass that to OpenCode or CodeCode, and it would actually have the reference where you could actually find some of those files. So it didn't have to pass through the whole code base to find where the important files were, and then it could ingest those itself to make its own decision. So then I would pass that to CodeCode and OpenCode, and I would iterate on the plan even a little bit more further just to fill out any gaps that we might have missed in the Cursor bit. And once I'm happy with the plan, I would then execute it in CodeCode or OpenCode, and I'll get a lot better and consistent result. And this is something I found really great. So on screen, you'll see this is kind of a graph of how, if you do start using CodeCode or OpenCode, it might feel a little bit hard. Might want to use Cursor a bit more because it feels a lot easier and something more similar to what you used to. Well, but as time goes on, you'll use Cursor less and less and use your CLI tools like CodeCode and OpenCode a bit more, and Cursor usage will drop off completely. The main point of this video is just how you should think about AI tooling. The way you should use Cursor is, if you're exploring unfamiliar code bases, I do that quite often because I enjoy trying to understand what the industry is doing, what open projects have got going on right now. Always use your CLI tools when executing well-defined repeatable class, so you know exactly how it's supposed to be scored. Your AI CLI tools should be your main coding engine, and you should really be defined and pinpoint with some of your instructions with your AI CLI tools to get the most out of them. So if you are looking to jump from Cursor to CodeCode or OpenCode, I would recommend starting off small, find the features from Cursor, and then switch to the CLI for implementation and really build up that habit. Use context carefully, be clear, and assign it to the right tools for the best result. And if you are on the fence of still wanting to switch from Cursor to any AI CLI tool because it maybe just feels indifferent, I'd love to hear what you're struggling with. Drop your comments down below. So balancing multiple AI tools really changed my workflow. So definitely try the systematic approach of using different AI tools for their strengths. And again, work bit by bit at it if you are new. And I'd love to hear your biggest AI coding frustrations that you're having right now. And drop those in the comments down below. Subscribe for more systematic development insights. I'm actually working on ways to better improve my AI development workflows right now. And there's a huge roadmap of other things to come in the next few months. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.